Some breaking news coming in. A shocking comment by Samajwadi Party Chief Mulayam Singh Yadav. Mulayam Singh Yadav has slammed the death penalty for three Mumbai rape victims, calling them bichara and victims of circumstances. His skewed reasoning that men sometimes commit mistakes as well. The Samajwadi Party Chief said women are exploiting anti-rape and anti-dowry laws, accusing men of rape after breaking up with them. Mulayam said he would change these laws if he comes to power.
ऐसे कानूनों को बदलने की कोशिश की जाएगी, दुरुपयोग करने वालों को सजा देंगे और झूठ रिपोर्ट करने वालों को भी सजा का प्रावधान किया जाएगा.
Amir Haq joining us on the phone line over the shocking statement made by Mulayam Singh Yadav. Amir, clearly Mulayam Singh Yadav is targeting or rather looking at a certain constituency when he's making this remark. Explain to us why he made this remark, in what context?
Talking statement there by Samajwadi Party Supremo, but Mulayam Singh Yadav is known to make such off-the-cuff statements earlier as well. I mean, I'm sure this is quite deplorable, and this will be taken up by other political parties as well. But the point is that we've seen in the past that there have been numerous times when Mulayam Singh Yadav has made very irresponsible and insensitive statements. Last time around, it was about Muzaffarnagar victims when he said that all those present in the relief camps there are in fact agents of the BJP and they are not the victims, not the riot victims in fact. So there have been numerous times when he's been pulled up by rival political parties. He's also gone back on his statements. But this time round, it seems absolutely shocking because there's no way he can justify his statement. Something that we understand is that perhaps he's targeting a particular constituency where he may be really hopeful of getting big, good votes by making such a statement, because there's no other there are no other circumstances that can explain making such a deplorable statement.
That's right, Amir. Clearly shocking by Mulayam Singh Yadav. There is no explanation in that in election time he's made this statement clearly to look at any particular constituency. What that particular constituency is, one is still trying to figure that out, in what context Mulayam Singh Yadav made this comment, or perhaps he was just revealing what his real sentiments are on the issue. Let's listen into Mulayam Singh Yadav again. You'll be shocked by this one.
हमारे जब हो गया तो लड़की जाके ब्याज देती मेरे साथ रेप किया, अब बेचारे को तीन को फांसी हो गई, क्या रेप में फांसी दी जाएगी? तीन लड़के हैं, गलती हो जाती है तो तीन को भी फांसी दे दी बंबई में. अब सोचिए आप, ऐसे कानूनों को बदलने की कोशिश की जाएगी, दुरुपयोग करने वालों को सजा देंगे और झूठ रिपोर्ट करने वालों को भी सजा का प्रावधान किया जाए.
Mamta Sharma from NCW joins us on the phone line. Ms. Sharma, Mulayam Singh Yadav says that these are poor men who commit rapes and sometimes mistakes happen.
बिल्कुल गलत बोल रहे हैं और मैं सोचती हूँ कि वोट लेने के लिए इस तरह का अपना जो उनके एटीट्यूड है, इस तरह का बयान बिल्कुल गलत है. उन्होंने जो भी कहा है बहुत गलत कहा है और इस पे मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि उनको, मैं चाहती हूँ कि देश की महिलाओं से माफी मांगे. जो जो महिलाएं इन सब बयान से अपने आप को और इनसिक्योर महसूस करेंगी उनको माफी मांगनी चाहिए. कमीशन इस पे कॉग्निजेंस लेगा, नोटिस देगा, लेकिन वोटों की राजनीति के लिए इतना बड़ा बयान देना कि लड़कों से गलती हो जाती है, मैं सोचती हूँ ये गलती नहीं है. बहुत बड़ा क्राइम है जो लड़के रेपिस्ट हैं, और उनके लिए इस तरह से बोलना, मैं सोचती हूँ उन्होंने बिल्कुल गलत कहा है।
Ranjana Kumari is also joining us on the phone line. Ranjana Kumari, I don't know if you've heard Mulayam Singh Yadav's soundbite or statement.
No, I have not heard because I have been busy.
Yeah, let me just brief you on what he said. He said at a rally in Moradabad, he said that they were referring to those who were convicted in the Mumbai gang rape attack, saying that these are mistakes that are often committed, and if he comes into power, he will remove the anti-rape law.
Mulayam Singh Yadav is showing to be a very irresponsible leader whose son is governing a state which has been converted into Jungle Raj. Recently, a 16-year-old was raped and burned to death in his state. This is the third largest rape cases that happened in the state of Uttar Pradesh. He has made a very irresponsible statement. What does he mean by small things? You know, what he's trying to encourage the rapists, that's what he's trying to do. He is just encouraging the rapists and trying to undermine the dignity of women. He must apologize to women of India. This is not acceptable at all, whether it is for vote, whether it is for any kind of politics. We will not tolerate such statements.
Okay, Shaina Ansi of the BJP also on the phone line. Shaina Ansi, Mulayam Singh Yadav says that those who were convicted in the Mumbai gang rape attack are bicharas and they should not have been convicted or given the death sentence because clearly when he comes into power, he says that he will remove such laws.
Clearly, the biggest bichara on May 16th is going to be Mulayam Singh Yadav himself. I think he's not just a regressive leader, but it shows you the stereotypical mindset where you kind of feel that you are one up on women and where you encourage this kind of jungle raj in the state. One has seen repeatedly, not just in Uttar Pradesh, but in lots of the leadership, a kind of insensitivity when it comes to rape and atrocities against women. What are we fighting for? We're fighting that the culprit should have fear of law. And there you have your leadership, whose son is the chief minister of the state, saying that exactly the opposite and to suggest that, no, you continue with your being perpetrators of crime and we'll shield you. It shows you the kind of hooliganism that we're supporting. And I really hope the biggest bechara on May 16th is Mulayam Singh Yadav.
Biggest bichara should be Mulayam Singh Yadav, says Shaina NC. But clearly he's looking at a certain constituency, perhaps a patriarchal society or stereotypical notions of where women should be, something that has been propagated by leaders like Mulayam Singh Yadav for the longest time. Let's listen in once again to that absolutely shocking, ridiculous statement which must not only be condemned, but I think action must be taken against Mulayam Singh Yadav. Let's listen in to Mulayam Singh Yadav. That soundbite in just a bit. We have Amir Haq on the phone line with us. Amir, any kind of remorse by the Samajwadi Party over this statement? Because what one is likely to hear next is that perhaps the Samajwadi Party will come out and say that he was misquoted.
Well, Maruk, nothing of this magnitude has happened before. But yes, we know that in UP's politics, you know, Samajwadi Party has been one party which has come to the fore very frequently, making huge promises to the electorate. Last time around, when the assembly elections took place in Uttar Pradesh, the Samajwadi Party included in its manifesto that all such innocent Muslim accused who've been accused under cases of terrorism will be set free by the government if at all the Samajwadi Party comes to power in Uttar Pradesh. There were other populist schemes which were promised as part of manifesto of the Samajwadi Party, be it distribution of laptops or tablets or Kanya Vidyadhan schemes. So, you know, this has been a part of the Samajwadi Party culture to make such promises to the electorate right before they go into polls. But definitely, this statement does not only border towards being a sexist statement, but also it is actually very, very deplorable and ridiculous on part of him, on part of such a senior leader who's supremo of a party, which in fact has a government in Uttar Pradesh, to be making such a statement.